Going on, guys. Another edition of the Connor and Mark show on Sunday. Mark Rogers. I'm Connor Gabe, reacting to a Philadelphia Phillies win. They today defeat the San Diego Padres 7-4 and take the series 2-3, finishing off their road trip. And now going to be heading back to Philadelphia tomorrow to start their 2-game interleague series at the Tampa Bay Rays. But we're going to be obviously talking about today's game, along with the news that broke earlier today that Alec Bohm, one of the Phillies' young best players who's been struggling all year, was sent down to AAA in Lehigh Valley. We'll be touching on that a little bit later in the episode. But Mark, big win for the Phillies today after a disappointing sweep from one of the worst teams in baseball against the Arizona Diamondbacks. The Phillies get back in the win column in a series. I believe this is the first series they've won since the Mets, you know, three-game series. It feels like forever ago at this point, just how long the baseball season is. But it's been that long since the Phillies won a series to get a win out in San Diego, 2-3. I believe they're 4.5 games out in Atlanta now. If I'm correct, maybe it's 5. I have to look back up, see what the result of the Atlanta game was today. I believe they won. But, yeah, so the Phillies are still chasing the Atlanta Braves, but they get the win today, 7-4. Mark, what was your reaction to today's victory?
Yeah, I mean, it was a culmination of what they did on Friday night and coming back to fruition a little bit. I mean, you know, Friday night, again, another gritty, you know, monkey win there, 3-2. But again, they looked really good last night. Obviously, the collapse from Nola in the ninth, which, you know, I think we'll dive into a little deeper. I personally think, you know, at that point, he's pitching really well, but he was up around the 110 pitch mark, 105. And I think at that time, need to bring in someone just to relieve him and take care of that ninth inning. Obviously, didn't happen, but the response today was great. And the main catalyst behind it, and again, leads to the news that we're going to touch on a little later, but was Rhys Hoskins coming back in the lineup and providing some much needed pop to this team that just really the bats were dormant the past few games, obviously in Arizona, scoring, you know, in all three games, two runs apiece, and then struggling to find a little bit of offense here today. So great offensive explosion. And I think that really gave, you know, confidence to Kyle Gibson, which, you know, he pitched phenomenal after that really, really rocky start, you know, could have really deterred them and really threw this game out the window early, but only allowing one run there and starting to settle down, you know, as the game progressed. And then obviously Phillies took the lead there and he really settled in all the way up to the ninth, you know, when he departed the game. So overall, I think against a really good San Diego team who's been plagued by injuries this year a little bit, still nonetheless a really good team and a great series win. And that's really what the Phillies have to do here. As you alluded to, the Braves did win today over the Orioles 3-1. So they're continuing to win. I believe the Mets are up right now, recording this at around 7 o'clock on Sunday night. So I believe the Mets are going to finally get a win against the Dodgers, but overall sticking on the Phillies, great series. And you know, they got another tough opponent heading back to Philly on Tuesday against the Tampa Bay Rays that they're going to have to take care of business against.
Yeah, and as it currently stands right now, I believe the Phillies are 5 games back from Atlanta. They're also going to be 5 games back from the wild card spot as well. The teams in front of them, I believe Cincinnati holds that second wild card spot. San Diego is right outside now, out of the playoffs, looking in. They've been really slumping, you know, this month and a half, and obviously they will drop 2-3 to Philadelphia, and also St. Louis is about, I believe, a game above Philadelphia in that wild card standing. So it would have been huge to get that win last night against San Diego to get the sweep. It looked like it should have happened, but it didn't come to fruition for the Philadelphia Phillies. But they are still, you know, a pretty good distance back from the Braves as well as the, you know, the rest of the wild card teams in that slot. So, but looking at the rest of the schedule here, the Phillies obviously are going to be coming back home. They're going to be facing the Tampa Bay Rays, and that's going to, I believe, be a 2-game series against the Tampa Bay Rays. And now I just lost the schedule on my computer, obviously. So
it's going to be 2-game series against the Rays. Yep.
Yeah, so it's going to be 2-game series against the Rays, and I believe their schedule starts to ease up a little bit. They're going to be playing some of the bottom dwellers after. I believe they're going to be hosting Pittsburgh later in a month, you know, Baltimore later in a month. And then the Braves, who really have had an easy schedule, you know, really this whole winning streak they've been on, they've been beating teams up that they should be playing. And, you know, they're taking care of their own business, but they're going to be entering a pretty tough stretch here of games. They'll be playing the Yankees for a 2-game series. They're going to have the Giants for a 3-game series and then go on the road to play the Dodgers. But after that, though, Mark, like, listen, like I said, they had a 5-game They have a 5-game lead on the Phillies in NL East. And look at the rest of the schedule after that stint I just mentioned. It's pretty easy to, you know, the rest of the way. I know they have a 3-game series at home against Philadelphia. That's going to be late September. They do have a 3-game series against San Diego. It's going to be right before the Philadelphia series. But really outside of that, could be playing the Rockies. They could be playing the Diamondbacks. They could be playing the Mets, who have been struggling. They could be playing the you know, like a lot of, you know, bottom dweller teams here. And as we're looking at the rest of the schedule, you know, we're what, the 22nd of August. We really have a little over a month here left of the MLB season. And the Phillies are going to start making up ground here because, you know, 5 games, it's not over yet, but it's going to be a little bit difficult. And to see where this team was at, they were in first place. I believe they had like a 2-game, you know, lead on both teams of the division. And for now, for them to be at the 5-game mark looking out is not good. So they're going to, if they want to make up ground, these next, so the Braves play the Yankees tomorrow, and then the last game against the Dodgers is going to be September 1st. So basically this last week of August is going to be huge for the Phillies and make up some ground here against Atlanta. They're going to start winning some games, and Braves have to start losing some against some good teams. And then getting in that rough ballpark of 2 games, you know, right around there, I think I'd be optimistic of the outlook for the Phillies moving forward.
I mean, it's really just taking care of business and really taking care of, you know, the opportunities that you're presented here. And, you know, looking forward here, they do have to obviously start putting some series together, and they started with that today. But, you know, taking a look here in the month of September, Phillies only have 2 days off. They have 10 divisional games in September, and they're actually all on the road. And, you know, looking at that, out of 27 games total that they have in September, all of their home games are against, obviously, opponents that are not in the division. So, as you alluded to, Pirates, Rockies, Orioles, Cubs they play. And again, they're going to have to take care of business against those really bottom feeder teams, which the Braves have been doing here. So, I think the biggest thing, and I said it earlier, I think pitching is going to be the biggest thing for this team. If they can get performances like they did with Kyle Gibson today and get some, you know, get the bats woken up a little bit, I think that's going to be the biggest thing. And taking a look here, you know, one of the things that does really worry me about this Braves team is their run differential is one of the best in the league, at 92, positive 92, yeah. Obviously. And the Phillies are at negative 22. So again, what that really tells me is just really trying to find some consistencies in this batting order. And, you know, if Reese can produce anything of close to what he did today on a consistent basis, in September will be, you know, great, because past years he's really struggled, down the stretch, and just, you know, Harper keeping up what he's doing. So, you know, it's a lot of moving parts here, but there, again, a lot of opportunity here for this Phillies team on a make track up with a very jam packed, September, and a majority of the games are at home. So, again, taking care of these opportunities that you're presented with, against very bad ball clubs and really going out and executing. And I think they can, you know, will they do it? That's remained to be seen with this team.
Yeah, we'll figure that out. But a big, obviously, addition of off the injury list today, before we get into the Alec Bohm news that happened earlier today, Rhys Hoskins was thrown back in the lineup. I believe he missed like 17 starts with his groin injury, but he was back in the lineup today. 2 home runs, pick up where he left off. He was obviously had a really hot bat before he got injured with the groin injury. I believe he got injured in the Washington series right before the home series against the Mets. So it's been a very long time since Rhys Hoskins has been healthy and in the lineup for the Philadelphia Phillies. He came back, made a big impact. And, you know, I got to be, you know, very optimistic about the outlook with Rhys Hoskins hitting the ball like that. And I know he's had a little bit of an up and down year. He's a very streaky player. I believe he's batting like 240-ish, but he has a lot of, you know, home runs and RBIs, and that's what you want out of a power hitter. So I'm really happy with, obviously, his performance today. I'm really happy to have him back in the lineup at that fifth spot. I know Andrew McCutchen didn't play today, but, you know, having those guys back, having a full lineup, healthy, ready to go on this stretch here to try and get back into the first place in the NL East is going to be huge. So I'm pretty, you know, pumped up to see Rhys Hoskins get 2 home runs today.
Yeah, I felt the same exact way. You know, I thought maybe that groin would maybe be bothering him a little bit, just being a bigger guy and, you know, having a little more weight on your body. But it looks like he's recovered pretty well. Obviously didn't display too much in the field of running, but at the plate, just getting the power behind the ball, looked like he didn't skip a beat. And honestly, you know, I know it's just one game, and I know it's 2 home runs there, but it looks like maybe some time off just did him well, and maybe he just had to really rest his body. So again, just really preparing, as I just said a little earlier, preparing for this month of September, this long stretch of games where he's really not been visible in the past 2 years, in my opinion. And I think he can make that up and really, you know, resurrect his career outlook in September if he can really produce at a high rate and anchor this ball club into some playoff success, hopefully.
All right, before we end this episode here on the Connor Mark Show, make sure you click subscribe on our YouTube page at Connor Mark Show, as long as follow us on our social media at Connor Mark Show on Twitter and Instagram. Alec Bohm was sent down today to AAA as they did reinstate Rhys Hoskins back to the active roster, being able to play. So, but Alec Bohm, though, obviously having a great rookie year last year, given everything that was going on with the pandemic and the shortened season and what was going on just with the MLB. For him to go out and bat 330 and really have a huge impact right away was great to see, and a big building block for the Phillies moving forward. This sophomore year has been a huge slump for him. He's just been lost at the plate and in the field. And with Tereas, you know, stepping into his role and really thriving for this Phillies team, it's been hard to keep him out of you know, the everyday lineup at that third base spot and finding excuses to throw Alec Bohm back out there. It ultimately led to him getting sent back down to AAA. I'm still optimistic about what Alec Bohm can do. I think we saw last year what he's capable of doing. He just has to, I mean, I think he relies way too much on slap hitting. I know that's the type of hitter he is. He's not really a big pull heavy guy. He's not a huge power guy, even though he has a big frame and size for, you know, a third baseman. He has that type of build for a big power hitting, you know, corner infielder. It's just not that his style of play, but really at the end of the day, he's not even hitting in general. So it's not like he's putting up the numbers he was putting up last year. He just can't hit the way he usually hits. I think this is the first time in his baseball career he's really struggled hitting the ball, and I think it's probably gotten to him. I know he's a young guy, so if this one needs to happen for him to get back on the right track for the Philadelphia Phillies and for him and his career, it's the right move. So I don't know what the timetable is going to be for him to get back in the majors, but it was definitely the right move to send him back down and give Tereas more at bats. And with Freddie Galvis probably coming back soon, it's, you know, you may want to rather have him out there than Bohm.
I mean, I agree in the same sense. I really think that you got to find what the main catalyst was of this really big slump, because last year he came in the major leagues. Looks like he was one of the best hitters on this team, probably was the best hitter on this team, as you alluded to, 338 average, 481 slugging, four homers, 23 RBIs in 40 games. So really picked it up quick, really looked like he was going to come into this season and be one of the Phillies anchors. But of course, as you said, has not been the case. And the biggest thing for me is I think the fielding issues, I think the fielding woes have kind of carried over to the plate in the sense of just confidence. And also a little bit of what you said, just really not, you know, enduring a lot of adversity in your career, as he's been a very sought off prospect coming up and a first round draft pick, third overall, and really had a good career at, I believe, Wichita State. So, yeah. You know, it might be a little bit of that. And I think, you know, you're totally correct. I think you send him down for a little bit, you give him some confidence, you really figure out this fielding situation. Because, you know, in my opinion, I think that was the final straw that broke the camel's back, in the sense of, you know, move them from third to first. And he had that really bad game in his appearance at first. I believe he had 2 or 3 errors. So I got to clean that up. And I think, you know, if he can gain some confidence in the field, I think it's going to translate over to the plate, and we'll be seeing him back in the majors, you know, before we know it here.
No, I agree. All right. Well, make sure you follow us on social media at Connor Mark Show. Subscribe to our YouTube page. And make sure you tune in on Saturdays on WCHE, 1520 and 95.3 WCHE for the Connor Mark Show, 10 in the morning, every Saturday. Obviously, there's going to be a lot coming up here with the Eagles. They're going to be playing the third and final preseason game this Friday. And then, obviously, Sixers and Flyers are not too far off on the horizon. But also college football, too, is coming up as well. And I'm excited about that. And, I mean, I believe that's, like, not this weekend. Or I think it's, like, 2 weeks away from now.
I don't think it's this Saturday coming up. I think the first game's going to be the Saturday after. So
that's what I believe. That's like going to be some like smaller school games coming up soon. I think it's less than a week away, but obviously with the big programs, you know, Penn State's going to be playing Wisconsin. I believe Alabama and Miami play the first weekend.
Yeah, that's going to be a good one.
Yeah, that's going to be a great game too. So there's a lot of good games. There's a couple ranked matchups on the first weekend. So it's going to be exciting.
Wisconsin, Penn State. Yeah, so it's going to be fourth.
It's going to be a big game. I'm excited. Big noon kickoff. So, yeah, so make sure you just subscribe and keep in touch. We'll be putting out more videos on that front. So we'll see you guys again.